Alright, boys and girls, welcome back. Tone King here, coming at you live from the Tone Lounge. We're going to do something new, exciting, special today. We are going to order a guitar. I'm going to call up Carvin Guitars. I have my laptop set up right over here, and we're going to order a guitar. So without further ado, here we go.
Calling Carvin. Please log on to carvin.com for 24-hour ordering and information, including product manuals. Please listen to this entire announcement before you make your selection. For a guitar, bass, or amplifier specialist, press 1. For a pro audio specialist, press 2. For assistance with an order already placed, press 3. For information on product repairs or return...
Carvin, this is Ed. How may I help you?
Hi, Ed. Can I speak with Keith, please?
Sure. Just a moment, please.
This is Keith. How can I help you?
Keith, this is the Tone King. How are you, man?
Hey, Tone King. How are you?
I am doing well. I'm ready to order my guitar.
All right. Just a second. Let me get an order screen up here, and we'll get started.
Okay. And we have the cameras rolling, by the way.
All right, I'm glad they're not on me.
All right.
Which model are we going to start with?
Well, I'm going to start here. I'm on the Carvin website, and I guess what I'd like to do is I want to see what you have in stock just to get an idea of different body shapes and all that good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And the ones that are in stock, these are ready to go, right?
Yeah, they're... set up and ready for immediate shipping.
So I see you have like super strat styles, you have single cut styles, double cuts. Let me take a quick peek here. The DC series. You've had the DC series for a long time.
That is correct.
Let me click on So to custom order, we go to guitars and basses, solid body electric.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and well, this is better than going to all guitars in stock because you kind of get to see and a look and feel of all the different models. So the DC series, so let me ask you a question. What is the difference between, let's say, a DC and a, like the carve top or like the 22, 24 fret carve tops, double cut?
Yeah, well, the DC... is a neck-through instrument, which means that the neck goes through the center of the body. The body sides are laminated onto the neck. The carve top is a set-neck instrument where the neck is actually glued into the body. Our set necks are slightly different than a lot of others on the market where our necks sit really deep into the body. They actually extend past the neck pickup. So the transfer of resonance and vibration is superior to what's out there right now.
And why would someone choose, let's say, the DC over, one of the set necks?
Not just personal preference. There's really no model that's better. They're just like tools in a toolbox. Whatever fits the job at hand. A lot of players come from a background of playing Gibsons. So they're used to the Les Paul shape. Or they're coming from, playing a PRS. And they're used to that body shape and design and style. So they want to stick with that. We offer them something a little bit different.
Okay. And what would you say, like, the DC series, like the neck through? What kind of player would be looking for something like that?
It's a really versatile instrument. It covers a lot of territory as far as tone. It's a nice transitional instrument if you're going from a bolt-on to a neck through, because you still get that nice punch that you would with a bolt on, but you do get a little bit more sustain with the neck through.
Got it.
And also you get the 24 fret, which is really nice. You get the double octave.
Okay. And when you say neck through, you're talking the same piece of wood all the way up at the tip of the headstock as the same piece of wood all the way to the tail of the body.
Right.
All right, let's do it. DC series it is.
Okay. Which model in the DC series we're going to go with today?
Okay, so we have the 600. By the way, the Jason Becker, very nice.
It's a beautiful guitar.
Very nice. I actually saw it at the NAMM show, and it's, you know, it's not only a nice guitar, but the fact that you guys are doing that as a tribute series, it's a nice job. Very nice job.
Yeah, I agree.
You know what? Let's do the one at the top, the DC 600, the two pickup guitar.
Okay.
And I'm just kind of scrolling through here.
Okay.
And I see it gets more ornate as you go down the list, huh? The DC 400.
Yeah, there's a lot of options in the DC series. And as you dig deeper into each series, the options that are available on each one are pretty extensive.
Okay. So we're going to, I like the DC 600 because it looks like a great place to start.
Okay.
Okay.
This is going to be a right-handed instrument, right?
Yes, sir. And by the way, I'm just so you know what I'm doing here, I am on your website and I'm kind of clicking through so I could kind of get some visuals as we order this.
No problem.
So DC 600, two pickup guitar.
Mm-hmm.
And I see here, okay, I click on Guitar Builder.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. By the way, this is a nice price.
Yeah, I agree.
USA made guitar, direct is $899, sale price is $799. Very nice.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to click on Guitar Builder. I get a pop-up window. And let me move that over a little bit. Okay. So click here to start building your DC 600. So, neck direction would be right-handed.
Mm-hmm.
Model upgrades. So, we have the Floyd, the Wilkinson, the Tune-O-Matic, and then the Fixed.
Right.
Okay, I'm going to keep it simple for myself. I'm going to do the Fixed Bridge.
All right.
Oh, wait, let me think. Tune-O-Matic Bridge and String Through. Let's do that.
Okay, so we're going to do the M-Bridge.
And just for my own edification here, fixed bridge with string through or tune-o-matic with string through, what's the difference?
Well, the fixed bridge with the string through, it's just going to look like your standard fixed bridge. The strings are going to be fed through the body.
Okay.
Come up under the bridge. Whereas with the tune-o-matic bridge, you're going to see where the strings are fed through the body.
Mm-hmm.
There's going to be ferrules. There's going to be a distance where the strings are going to extend to the bridge and then on to the headpiece. So you're actually going to see the strings as they come out of the body on the tune-o-matic bridge.
So you actually, so both get the same, accomplish the same goal. One is more, I guess.
Well, not necessarily. The tune-o-matic is going to get you a little bit more sustained.
Got it.
Than the fixed bridge.
Okay. And that sounds good. I'm going to click continue building order.
Okay.
And now we get to the fun stuff. Let's see. So body options. You have 9 different woods, body and neck wood.
Right.
And let me take a quick peek here. So just looking at the bodies, alder, swampish, koa mahogany. Give me a starting point. What do you recommend? I like, you know, rock and metal style music. What do you recommend for something like that?
Well, what kind of tonal qualities are you looking to get from the instrument? Are you looking for more bottom end? Or are you looking for more even tone? Or are you looking for punch? Bite?
That's a good question. You know what? I usually play with gain.
Mm.
And I usually like it to cut right through. I don't really do much with drop tunings. I don't do a whole lot with clean. So I just, from a tone perspective, I just want it to sound very even, a very, very crisp and even.
Okay. In that case, I'd go with the standard neck and body wood, the alder body, maple neck. Alder wood is a great tone wood. It's been around since day one.
Okay.
It's going to offer you the most even, even tone.
I guess with something like a mahogany, it's going to be a little darker, right?
Yeah. It's going to be warmer. The top end's going to be subdued. It's going to have more mid-range.
What is, you know, it's interesting. You have walnut. You don't see that too often. What would you get with a walnut body?
Nice bottom end.
Really?
Yeah, good clear bottom end punch. Mid-range is going to be nice and neutral. It's not going to have a bump in the mid-range.
Mm-hmm.
Top end's going to be nice and open and clear. The thing is it is a heavy wood, But if you want a heavy instrument, you know, on the heavier side, walnut's a good wood to choose.
Do you map any of these to certain styles of music?
Not necessarily, because you see Strats played in just about every style of music. Okay. And typically they're alder bodies, swamp ash. You know, it really depends. It really depends.
Okay. Well, let's I'm going to go with your suggestion. You said maple neck alder body, right?
Yep. I think that's a good choice.
And then top wood options. Okay, so how does this work? So when I click on top wood, well, top wood options is below, and then I pick the top.
Yeah, if you click on book match flame top and then go continue building, it's going to show you all the flame colors.
Okay.
With the price.
Got you. Also, you have a BBE natural top wood binding with straight edges.
Right.
What is that doing? Is that kind of like a scrape, like you tape it off?
Yeah, what it's going to do is it's going to have those edges straight.
Mm-hmm.
They're not going to be beveled in any way. They're going to be pretty straight. And the side of the top is going to be unpainted, so it's going to give you a natural binding effect. So you're going to see the natural maple color.
Okay.
The transitions from the top color to the back of the instrument.
Okay, so let's select that. And let's do the book matched flame maple top.
Okay. So once you click on that, then it's going to give you all the color options.
Okay.
Flame maple.
So here we go. So I am at body option finishes. Let's see. Clear gloss, satin, tongue oil. And this is for the top coat. Okay. So this is the part. This is the top of the guitar where the pickups are and everything else, right?
Right.
Something.
Now keep in mind, if you decide to go with a tongue oil finish,
right,
you can't go with a color.
Got it. Okay.
It'll be the natural flame.
No, I definitely want a color.
Okay, so we're either going to choose clear gloss or satin.
Yeah, I think clear gloss for the top is the way to go.
Okay.
Okay. And then when I go down to select one of the color options, okay, so here we go. I think this one is... You know, when I was at the NAMM show, I saw a guitar that had the blue-green burst.
Yeah, deep dragon burst.
Deep dragon burst flame. And it says includes DTS. What is DTS?
Deep triple step stain. So basically what that does is it enhances the flame. It gives you more of a dimensional look, almost like a three-dimensional look.
Got it. Okay. So I'm gonna select... Oh, actually, if you hover over, you could see the different finishes.
Yeah, you can see an example of it.
I'm curious, what's your most popular finish?
Wow, that's a good question. We sell a lot of everything. I would probably say the classic sunburst is always a good seller. The reds and the blues.
Nice. Okay.
To be honest with you, we sell a lot of everything, to tell you the truth. Yeah.
I'm curious, how popular is the deep dragon burst that I'm selecting?
It's pretty popular.
Okay.
We do quite a bit of those. It used to be a custom option.
Okay.
We didn't offer it as a standard. We offered it as a custom option, and the more people saw it, the more they asked for it. So we made it as an option available.
So based on popular demand, huh?
Exactly.
Well, I'll tell you what. What caught my eye was the fact that you just don't see that too often. It was a very exciting finish.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. Okay, so I'm going to choose the deep dragon burst. And then it says burst edges.
No need to select anything there because you're getting a dragon burst.
Got it. So that's already, the burst is built in, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And then it says flame and quilt maple top upgrade. And that's already built in too, right?
That's correct.
Beautiful.
We've already chosen a flame top.
Okay. Awesome. And then it says back finishes.
Mm-hmm.
Black sides with black burst back, or black gloss back and sides.
Mm-hmm. So basically, that first choice, the BBB, that's going to paint the sides of the body, not the top, but just the body. It's going to paint that black, and then that's going to transition to a black burst on the back. The center will be the dragon, so I wouldn't recommend that. That would be, in my opinion, kind of ugly.
Okay.
Just to be frank with you.
No, I appreciate that.
Yeah. I would opt for the BGB, which is the black gloss back and sides.
Okay.
That's
going to
paint the sides and the complete back of the instrument black, and that offers a great contrast with that deep dragon burst top and that natural body binding.
Okay. Now, I don't remember the back side of the neck. Did we get there already?
No, actually, we may have. It's going to be on the next page.
Okay, so I'm going to.
We haven't gotten there yet.
Got it. Okay, I'm going to click continue building guitar.
Okay.
And we're moving along. We're on page 4 or 7. So neck, headstock, and fingerboard options. Okay, so I could hover over and get the.
Yeah, one thing that we didn't decide on. Do you want to go with the black gloss back and sides?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, black gloss back and sides. You recommend that, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. And what if I didn't want anything there? Do you have an option where you don't have to select that?
Sure, yeah. The if you don't choose that, the back of the instrument is going to be the dragon burst. But one thing to keep in mind, the top is a deep triple step stain.
Right.
So it's going to have that color that's going to really pop.
And you're not going to have that on the back.
Exactly, because you don't have a flame top.
Got it. Okay, got it. So yeah, so let's, and I like the idea of having the, kind of the natural binding that separates and then having the black back. I like that. It sounds good.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to click continue building. And now I'm at neck, headstock, and fingerboard options. Let me just hover over and take a quick peek here. What do you recommend here?
I would probably opt for a 5-piece maple neck.
Okay.
The neck comes standard as a 1-piece,
okay,
which is stable. It's strong the way that we dry our wood and process the necks. Super stable. You're not going to have any issue with the neck wandering.
Okay.
But a 5-piece maple neck is going to offer you a little bit more stability.
Okay. Now, let me see. So we have 5-piece mahogany. We don't want to do mahogany. We already chose the neck, didn't we?
Well, we chose the neck and body wood option, which was the alder body maple neck.
Okay.
This does is it gives you the option to choose a 5-piece neck.
Got it.
The reason I would recommend a 5-piece maple
is
that you've already chosen, you know, the alder body maple neck. You're going to be painting the back of the neck and body, you know, black.
Right, so,
why choose multiple wood options when it's going to be covered up?
Got it. Okay, so I'm going to do 5-piece all maple neck, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then optional back of neck finishes. Clear satin tongue oil, painted satin finish. So are we going to do painted satin? If I want to do the back satin, not so I don't have like that gloss feel.
Right.
Is that the clear satin? Which one would I choose here?
Well, if you want the back of the neck to be black.
Okay.
I would choose a painted satin finish on the back of the neck. If you choose a clear satin finish on the back of the neck, it's going to be maple.
Oh, it tape like you would tape it off and then it would
be. Exactly.
Okay. What do you recommend?
If you're going to do a satin, I do the painted satin. Then that way it still has that consistent black color on the back of the neck.
Okay. And then you also have the nice contrast between the black satin back of
the
neck.
And the gloss.
And the gloss. Okay, I like the contrast. So I'm going to do painted satin finish back of neck matches body color. And that's actually matching, in this case, the black, since that's the back body color.
You got it.
Okay. Headstock shapes. Let me take a quick peek here. I like the 6-string pointed, but I also see you have a reverse.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm all about reverse.
Okay.
You know, the inlines are cool too.
Yeah.
But I don't know. What's your opinion? What's your opinion on this guitar?
I like the pointed headstock on this guitar because of the body shape. I like that flat top look. And the pointed headstock to me looks better on the flat top. If we were going to do like, let's say a DC 400, where it has the, and do a rounded body, the inline headstock, in my opinion, would look better.
Okay. So this one you're recommending 6-string pointed?
Yeah. And we can do that in a reverse.
Let's do that. Done. And then I have headstock wooden finish.
Right. white, so we would go with a flame maple headstock overlay to match the body.
Okay, and that is...
FPH.
Flame maple headstock matches body. Okay, got that. Fingerboard wood. So you have ebony, bird's eye, flamed. You know, it's interesting that you have, you know, ebony is usually premium wood.
Mm-hmm.
Usually you see, you know, kind of the, you know, you would typically see maple or rosewood and then like an upcharge for ebony. And it's nice to see that that's standard here.
Yeah, well, our instruments are premium, so we figure why not offer a premium wood as a fingerboard.
Yeah. What now, what do you recommend here?
I like ebony. The bird's eye maple looks nice with the deep dragon burst. It kind of depends on what hardware color you're going to go with as well. If you're going to go with black hardware, I would go with an ebony fingerboard.
I'm thinking about that one. I know I don't want rosewood. A maple, flamed maple. So you actually do flamed maple fingerboard?
Mm-hmm.
Do you happen to have a picture of what that looks like on your website that you're aware of?
Yeah. If you go to... You click on guitars and basses again and then go to solid body electrics.
Guitars and basses.
Yeah, where we first started.
Solid body electric guitars, okay.
And then click on 22 fret carved top guitars.
Okay.
And then click on, scroll down and click on the CT624.
CT, did I miss it? I see CT6. Do I have to go down a little bit more?
Yeah, a little bit more.
I see CT6 California single cut.
Hey, did you click on 24 fret?
Maybe I didn't. Hold on. Let me back up one.
Yep.
Oh, 24. I'm sorry. Okay.
Click on the
CT624.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then once you're there, where you were before, where it says Guitar Builder to the right.
Yes.
To the right of that and below, it says CT624 Guitar Gallery.
Yes, yes.
On that.
And oh, this is nice. You offer a guitar gallery for each individual.
Looks like they don't have it in here.
Oh, wow, look at that. You actually have the finish that we were looking at.
Yeah, there's the finish, but it's got a ebony fingerboard. I was looking for the bird's eye maple fingerboard.
Okay.
Let me see if I can find one.
That's a nice finish.
That is. Beautiful. Oh, great. There's just a plain maple fingerboard. I'm going to try one other spot.
Okay. And while you do that, I'm actually going to go to the DC series and see the gallery there.
All right.
Actually, it's in the DC series. I see it right here.
Oh, great, great.
DC 600 Deep Honey Burst Flame Maple. Flame Maple Fingerboard. Wow, interesting. That's a serious upgrade that you guys offer.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, you don't see that anywhere.
I know. I haven't seen too many of them out there.
Interesting. Okay, let me close that window. I'm going to come back to my order board. Okay, I'm back. So, where were we? We were looking at fingerboard woods.
Right.
So you think ebony is the way to go on this one, huh?
I do like ebony fingerboards for a lot of reasons. It's super hard, very durable, and it offers that nice extra ping on the top end, that nice clear openness on the top end.
Mm-hmm. And I guess this one would also match nicely the black back that we went with.
Exactly.
Okay, done. Sold.
Okay.
Fingerboard options. Okay, I'm actually hovering over. Oh, you know what? Since we have the burst, I think we should get like an abalone to match the...
the green and blue.
The green and the blue.
Yeah.
So the question is, which inlay style do we want to go with?
Well, if you want to go understated, the dots are the way to go.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to go over the top, well, not over the top, but if you want a more dramatic look, the blocks are nice. And then you can do middle of the ground. You can do diamonds or the abalone signature inlays.
I'm thinking diamonds. It's not as subtle as a dot, but it's not as bold as a block.
Yeah.
Okay, so now do we do black? Let me see here again. Abalone diamond, yes? DAB?
Right. Yes.
Okay. Got that. And then we have frets. So this is where it gets tough for me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why would someone choose, let's say, a medium jumbo over a jumbo versus a low wide? Like, give me the lowdown on choosing a fret.
Yeah, the medium jumbo is kind of like the industry standard. You'll find that more often than any other size. The jumbo shredders like that because it requires a light touch.
Okay.
Jumbo fret, if you dig in, you're actually going to bend the note sharp.
Got it.
You play with a light touch, you're able to play it light and fast. So the jumbos are good for that. The low wides, if you do a lot of sliding, the fret profile is at its minimum. So you're able to get the action extremely low.
Okay.
And if you kind of slide into notes, it makes it much easier. I would, if it were me, I would opt for just a medium jumbo, and I would do it in a stainless, because stainless are virtually indestructible. You'll never have to refret your instrument.
Okay, so stainless,
medium jumbo.
Medium jumbo, okay. So I selected that. So the jumbo sounds like almost like what somebody would, what you'd get out of a guitar that was scalloped.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, so I selected STF, right? Stainless medium jumbo. Radius, fingerboard radius. I think probably standard here is the way to go, right?
I'd agree.
Okay. So I'm going to click continue building guitar. I am on page 5 of 7. And let's take a look here. I'm thinking I don't necessarily want active electronics.
Mm-hmm.
So we're looking at C22, B, T, M, H. Give me kind of the lowdown on the C22s versus the M22 or the H22.
Yeah, the H22 is a Holdsworth pickup.
Okay.
Pickup was designed in conjunction with Alan Holdsworth. They come standard in his model guitars. He plays fusion jazz, so you're going to get a tone that's along those lines. Nice bell tone, open, even tone.
Okay.
If you go with the M22 SD, that's a super distortion.
Ah.
So metal.
Okay.
The C22T is a good pickup. It's not quite as versatile as the B, which comes standard. So if you play a variety of music like classic rock, a little bit of metal even, you can play blues. You can even play fusion jazz with it. I'd probably say the C22 is the most versatile out of that group.
Okay, I think I kind of like the M22.
Okay.
So let's go with the M22 SD for the bridge.
All right.
And I'm sorry I didn't take your recommendation on that one.
No, it's no problem.
You had me sold at super distortion. And then for the neck pickup, this is probably where I could add a little versatility, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which one would you say maps nicely?
Actually the M series, because they're from the same era.
Okay.
I would go with an M22V.
Okay, done. So I have the M22V. And the pickup colors, I'm thinking, do we switch it up a little bit and get, like, because we have the black back, we have the black fingerboard.
Mm-hmm.
Do we do something Do we do something with cream to I don't know, add some flair there? What's your, artistically, what's your opinion?
It's wide open with regard to pickup color. I think you could go with cream and black with a black bezel, or you could go cream and black with a cream bezel. I would probably do cream and black with a black bezel, or all black.
Black coils with cream bezel, cream black with cream black with black. So you were saying the zebra pickups are pretty hot, huh?
Well, what you're doing is getting your M22 SD in a zebra.
Right.
It doesn't change the profile of the amp as far as performance. It's just a color option.
But cosmetically, you don't. I'm trying to think. Like usually, you see them on like custom guitars or. You know, it's not your run of the mill, right?
Right. Yeah.
So let's go with that. Let's do the cream black.
With the black bezel?
Probably. What do you think? Yes, right?
Yeah, I do the black.
Okay. So let's do cream and black with the black bezel.
All right.
I like that. I think it just adds a little contrast to the body, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cream black with the black bezel. I'm going to click on continue building the guitar. So now, this is where we get into hardware. For this guitar, do you think we go with black hardware?
I would.
Okay. Strings, I'll just, standard is fine. Headstock logo.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Oh, abalone logo.
Absolutely.
Yep, okay. You made that one easy.
Yeah.
And miscellaneous options. We probably want to do metal with abalone inlay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, you could choose more than one here. Okay, so let me see. Metal knobs with white, rosewood knobs, Dunlop strap locks, white pearlzoid buttons, ivory Graftech nut. What nut do you use as a standard nut?
Comes standard with a graphite nut.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, yeah, we're good there.
Mm-hmm.
Cream truss rod cover. There is no truss rod cover on mine because it's string through.
Well, truss rod cover is going to be at the headstock. So you are.
Oh, right. Oh, you know what? Maybe we should do that so it has that little bit of match from the pickups. What do you think?
Yeah, that would look nice. You could also engrave it, put Tone King on it.
Oh, we'll definitely have to do that.
Yeah.
Okay, so which one was it? Cream truss rod cover. Do you agree that, you know, you have the cream pickups, you know, the matching headstock, you should have a little bit of cream up there too, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll do cream truss rod cover. And then let's engrave that. Indicate how would you like to have truss rod engraved. Engraving will be exactly as you indicate below. First line. Let's call it the Tone King. Or let's see.
Yeah, 10 characters, okay. 2 lines.
I have to think about this one. I came unprepared for this. So let's see. First line.
So you could go the on the first line and then Tone King on the second line.
Ah, okay. Now, is it case sensitive if I type it all in uppercase? Does it leave it in uppercase?
Yes.
Gotcha, okay.
Or you could do first letter caps.
Gotcha, okay. Let's see. Okay, no, I like that. I like that. Okay, the Tone King. So on one line it'll say, and under it it'll say Tone King.
Mm-hmm.
Got it, okay. And then cases, I think a black Tolex is good. And
strap locks?
What'd you say?
Did you want to get strap locks?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
I don't think so, because then you'd have to have it on your strap, right?
Yeah. Well, the cool thing about the Dunlop strap locks is that you can use it with a strap, with a locking mechanism, or without. So if you were to ever leave your strap that has the locking buttons on, you have another strap that does not, you can still use it.
Gotcha. All right, so let's do that. I'm gonna put Dunlop strap locks.
Okay.
And I think that is everything. I think that'll do it.
Yeah, we've reached the end.
So I'm gonna click continue to accessories so we could see the straps, cables, guitar stands. Let's see. And then you know what? I'm tempted to add the guitar strap.
Okay.
The Carvin guitar strap. And I'll put the other end of the strap lock buttons on there.
Yep.
And complete and add to cart. Page 7 of 7. Here is the final order. I got a discount. And this looks great.
Yeah.
Okay.
Got yourself a beautiful instrument.
Thank you. So I'm going to proceed to secure checkout and all that. I'm obviously not going to roll that on camera.
Right. But what I'll do is, once you've done that, I'll send you a copy to your email address for you to look over.
Okay.
If you see anything that you want to change or add, just give me a call back. And basically the procedure is, once you've placed the order, once the custom shop has invoiced it, you've approved it, and the custom shop invoices it. If you make any changes after that point, there's a $50 change fee. So
gotcha.
That's why we send you a copy for you to look over, make sure everything's perfect before we proceed.
Awesome. Well, Keith, thank you very much. I really appreciate you going through this with me. This was actually very exciting. I kind of learned a lot in the process.
Yeah, it's always fun to do them. I mean, I've done hundreds of guitar orders over the years, and it's still fun to do.
Nice.
Get customers what they want.
Do you get a lot of people just pointing and clicking going through it, or does the phone usually ring at the other end?
Well, no, they call in, and I pretty much just guide them through if they have any questions. Occasionally, we do get customers that call in that know exactly what they want.
Nice.
At that point, I'm just, you know, punching in the options.
Sure.
But I'd probably say about 65 to 70% of the time, I'm doing a little coaching.
Yeah, no, I'll tell you what, it was, you know, you have to do a little bit of technical detail, fashion consultant. You wear many hats at the other end, huh?
Right.
All right, Keith, thank you very much, and I'll touch base with you afterwards, and I appreciate you going through this with me.
No problem, and I'll send that email to you right away.
You got it. Thank you. Take care.
All right, you too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right, so there it is. We got our custom order Carvin guitar, and I'm pretty stoked. This is exciting stuff. And, you know, it's interesting because... it's nice that they have the option. It's nice that you could also call and they could walk you through, you know, again, like I said, you're doing a little, you know, does this work? Does that work? You have that whole, you know, you need to, like, pickups. He was providing me with some detail on different pickups. But then when you get to, like, what color should they be? Then you kind of get into that whole consultant mode of, well, this would work and that wouldn't. And by the way, that was a good call in terms of having the back match. And I guess when you're doing the flame in the front on the burst on the front with the flame maple, you don't necessarily want the burst on the back where there is no flame. So that black back sounds real exciting. So anyway, that is the video of the day. I just ordered a Carvin guitar, and what I'm going to work with Carvin on is here's the surprise. We're going to record the build process, the entire steps of the build of this guitar right here. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed that video. I'm going to leave everybody off with two of those right there. Thank you. I think that's it. And Keith, in case you're watching this video, man, thank you for your time in working with me here. Later.